As the ANC heads to its 55th national conference, the ANC in Limpopo, the chairperson there, Stanley Mathabatha, has received 1,492 nominations for the position of national chairperson in the party's top six. Well, he will be going up against the current national chairperson, Gwede Mantashe, and the NEC member, David Masondo. Mbali, Thethani is in Groblersdal. And you're about to have a sit-down with Stan Mathabatha, Mbali. Does he think that he really has a chance to take this one this time around? Mantashe has been holding on for dear life into these top six positions. Can he topple him?
That's certainly right, Tholi. And of course, those are some of the questions that we will indeed ask Stanley Mathabatha, the ANC's Limpopo chairperson, in terms of, you know, looking at the names which have already been announced by the ANC in its 55th leadership race for this year's conference. His name has come up, and of course, he seems to top the list when it comes to those who have been nominated for the position for chairperson of the ANC. And I'm going to bring him in now, Stanley Mathabatha, the ANC chairperson here in Limpopo. One would ask, are you up to task? You have been brought in by the branches. They've shown confidence in you. A number of them thinking that you have what it takes to take over the position of national chairperson.
I suppose. Let me start by greeting your viewers. I suppose I'm up to task because one, so many branches in the country says they are confident that you can do the task. You are equal to the task. Why should you doubt yourself? I think I am equal to the task. I've got a very long profile within the African National Congress. I joined the African National Congress as a teenager, and that should tell you the kind of experience that I gathered within this movement.
That conference is just about 2.5 weeks away. You know, when it comes to your nomination for that position of national chairperson, should you in the next few weeks assume that position, you know, what do you think you'll be doing differently when it comes to, you know, the responsibilities that the national chairperson of the ANC has?
A simple thing that goes through the veins and the network of thinking of the African National Congress, which is very central, is the unity of the African National Congress. That's where we are going to start. What one would want to do as the chairperson, because I will be chairing the National Executive Committee of the ANC, I must direct the meetings of the African National Congress in those very senior, in that very senior structure of the African National Congress. I must direct them in such a way that we inspire confidence to the ordinary people on the ground. We inspire confidence to the branches of the African National Congress. When we emerge, you know, the chairperson of a meeting plays a very important role of facilitating discussions and directing the meeting so that the meeting does not become chaotic. If you understand what the African National Congress stands for or what you want to achieve as a short term, as a tactical goal or objective that time, as the chairperson, you can direct a meeting in that direction so that the meeting at the end of the day achieves that tactical or strategic objective of the meeting. So that's where one would want to start as the chairperson of the African National Congress, the unity of the African National Congress.
And coming in, should you ascend to that position, you're coming into a very broken ANC, a very divided ANC, an ANC that has, you know, for the past couple of months, we've seen major divisions, especially now, with the issues around Palapala also plaguing your president. You know, how will you ensure when it comes to that issue around unity and renewal that you will also be able to be part of?
Hey, the picture that you're painting of the African National Congress It's basically a carcass. Well, you're talking about something like a carcass, a shell, an empty shell, which I don't think is the case. Yes, we've got factions now in the African National Congress. The ANC is fragmented in a large degree. But as to whether it is broken, I don't think so. The ANC is still intact. And the ANC will elect a leadership that will deal with these factions. You know, if you remember quite vividly, it's not like the ANC, the factions in the ANC are starting now. We have had factions since 1930. If somebody can tell you about the ANC conference of 1930, where Presley Sargasame was elected as president, people will tell you that the ANC was heavily divided at that time. The ANC had serious factions at that time. In exile, everywhere, the ANC has always had factions, but the most important thing was how are these factions being managed? How is the leadership inspiring confidence to the ordinary masses on the ground, inspiring confidence to the ordinary members of the ANC in such a way that the ordinary members of the ANC sees the ANC as something, as an institution, rather than a group of individuals. Group of individuals supporting Cyril Ramaphosa. Group of individuals supporting Nkosazana and Dlamini Zuma. Group of individuals supporting so-and-so, you know. We are not a conglomeration of groups as the African National Congress. We are a unit, an entity called the African National Congress, united around one strategic objective of the National Democratic Revolution.
One issue that has plagued somebody that you as a province, and I remember just earlier this year, as being one of the first really to support and endorse your current president, ANC President Cyril Ramaphosa, for a second term. You know, months later, plagued by the issues around Palapala, today we finally heard from Parliament that report has been handed over. What is your reaction in terms of where we find ourselves with the issues and that cloud hanging over the president of the ANC?
Firstly, I would want to, now that I'm a candidate, remember when I pronounced I was not a candidate, and I did not know that I may be a candidate that time. You know. Now that I'm a candidate, I would want to stay away from talking about other candidates, because that is an ANC. You know. Remember an ANC? In the ANC, we believe in the democracy that talks about party. That is said to be participatory democracy, which finds its expression in democratic centralism. So that democracy says to you that you are not just an individual in the ANC, you are part of a collective. Now, if you are contesting for a position and you start talking about other candidates, it will seem as if you are saying to those candidates, or you are saying to the ANC, I would prefer to work with this one and not this one. Because this I don't like this one, I like this one. But that in itself, for me, is an ANC. Because the ANC, in the ANC, we are all seeing each other as comrades. Whether we contest each other or don't contest each other, we are comrades of the African National Congress. You must be prepared to work with everybody. If you want to understand, to know where Limpopo stands now about the presidency, I would direct you to a provincial secretary who's not a candidate, who's leading the campaign of the Provincial Executive Committee of Limpopo. For me, I would want to stay out of talking about other candidates.
Mr. Mathabatha, bringing me to my next point, I remember earlier this year, even at the policy conference, when we talk about the resolutions of the 2017 conference, now that we head into this 2022 conference of the ANC, something you spoke out against, and you had said that one of the policies you will be bringing to the floor and you want discussed at this conference is the issue around the step-aside resolution. Absolutely. Do you still share the sentiment that it's something
Very firmly so. You know, you must understand our position as Limpopo when it comes to the issue of step-aside. We are not saying that you don't need an instrument such as that, a policy instrument such as that, you know, to deal with the kind of ill discipline that we are seeing in the organization today. We are saying the way in which it was crafted from conference was not up to scratch. As a result, that made it difficult for the leadership, being the NEC, to implement it. That is why they were sort of changing it along the way of implementing it. And we believe, as Limpopo, that to a large extent, this step-aside resolution was weaponized, politically weaponized against some comrades by other comrades, for whatever reasons. You know. So, hence, we are saying, if you get another police instrument, that will still achieve the gains that you wanted to achieve with step-aside. Why don't we do so? And scrap this one. If you want to continue with step-aside, then let's craft it better in such a way that it cannot be abused. Because currently, we are of the view that it has been abused. It has not been used fairly.
But do you think that there's still room for a rule like step-aside to stay, like you're saying, and, you know, in terms of discussing how it should be carried out in the party, you know, how different should it be to ensure to the public? And I remember even this year saying that you want to deal with corruption. You know, how do you ensure that you are accountable to the public, that, you know, leaders who are corrupt need to account?
Surely you'll agree with me that you don't only need to step aside to deal with corruption. There are so many measures that you can apply to deal with corruption. Step aside was just one policy instrument that you can use, that we wanted to use. As to whether it did achieve its intended objectives is another thing. For if you ask me, I would say no, you know. But you ask somebody, he will definitely, or he or she will definitely have a different view. But for me, I would say it did not. Mm-hmm. But in terms of the policy prescripts of the African National Congress, starting from the constitution of the ANC, if you've got firm and strong leadership in the African National Congress, you will not need the step-aside resolution.
All right. Thank you very much. Of course, that is Stan Mathabatha, the ANC chairperson, who's also ANC chairperson here in Limpopo, who's also running for the position of national chairperson in the upcoming 55th National Conference of the ANC.